So you're all very welcome to this evening's Marketing Institute event, which we are delighted to have arranged and promoted in conjunction with Cork Chamber. My name is Vincent Scanlon, and I'm chairperson for the Marketing Institute of Ireland at the South Region. Representing Cork Chamber this evening, we welcome President John Mullins. Welcome, John. Thank you for joining us. I know you have an extremely, extremely busy diary. Extremely busy diary, so your presence here is very much appreciated. Thanks for keeping us on your list. Welcome to Jenny O'Flynn, our own Vice Chair of our Marketing Institute and also Chairperson of our Marketing Ball. Could I also extend a special welcome to our presenter this evening, Don O'Leary from Google. Thank you for accepting our invitation to present to us as part of our calendar of events, and welcome home to Cork, most importantly. As I've mentioned, tonight's event is in association with Cork Chamber. Could I ask President John Mullins to greet you? I know digital marketing is close to John's heart. So John, if you'd like to say a few words, thank you.
Thank you very much indeed, Vincent. Thank you for the invite, and clearly we're delighted to be associated with the Institute with this very fine event and very apt event, considering the role of technology in business today. Can I just say, while I was doing a bit of research on this, I actually looked at a Harvard Business Review from last month, and there was commentary about the future of retail. I know now, ladies, this is going to be difficult to actually fathom, but that successful companies will engage, this is retail companies, will engage customers through omni-channel retailing. That is a mashup of digital and physical experiences. Now, I'm trying to figure out how my wife is going to avoid Mahon Point and go online. And certainly men, by the way, as we all know, are useless when it comes to retailing because they're just impulse buyers. So online is quite clearly very useful for men, apart from when they're purchasing a car. And I think in terms of where we're moving, if you look at where Amazon is at, and it's quite interesting in this article, again, it's worth looking at. Amazon's return on investment as an online marketer of books, with clearly 25% of books in North America now actually online on Kindles, on iPads, on Google devices now, Androids, etc. They have a 17% over the last 5 years return on investment, when your average retailer in the United States has actually had a return on investment of 6.5%. That just tells you that marketing through a digital space quite clearly has certainly captured the imagination of the book market. Can I just point out, before Don comes out, Google AdWords and Google Analytics for us was fundamental to understanding where we were with respect to actually the success or not of the big switch. In 1 month, in the first month, 30,000 customers joined Bord Gáis on the big switch by accessing Google AdWord. By Google Analytics, we were able to determine how many of the customers came through that channel to us. In fact, actually, because we were buying everything around electricity, if you were looking for a Swedish light bulb on Google, up would have come, first up would have been the big switch. Because we are impulsive. We always go to the top of a Google listing. And in terms of marketing your products or services, people will say, well, this crowd must be good because they're the top of the Google list. I just wanted to give you that flavor of how successful it has been in my own day job. What I hope, and I know I've spoken to Don earlier about what Don is going to speak about this evening. And by the way, whatever we think about what technologies are there today, the future is going to be stunning in terms of how the millennials, and I'm now speaking marketing, so I better be careful, how the millennials are actually fundamentally going to engage with all of our businesses as we go forward. Because 10 years from now, the topic, I think, Vincent, that we're speaking about today will actually dominate the topics that you're fundamentally going to be talking about as marketers at every one of your sessions. So with that, thanks for listening to me. Thanks for the invite, Vincent, and delighted to be working with you tonight on this, and to Don as well.
Thanks very much, John. So Don presents to us this evening on marketing in the digital age. Would you please give a warm Cork homecoming welcome to Don O'Leary.
Thank you very much, Vincent. Thank you, John. Thanks to the Chamber and the Institute. As a Cork man, very proud to be here this evening. I was just coming into the hotel earlier on, and Paul O'Connor met me at the door, and I was just after coming down off the train from Dublin, and he said, you know, is it the first time that you've been here? And I said, well, I'm actually from Blarney. And he goes, well, at least you're from Cork anyway. So I knew I was in the right room. Thank you very much for the opportunity to talk tonight. It's actually a critical time within the industry at the moment, for Google and technology, there's a lot of things happening. There's a lot of converging technologies. There's a lot of trends that are happening, and it's an exciting time for us. It should be an exciting time for you guys as well. Where we see change, we see opportunity. I see it my job this evening to maybe highlight some of those opportunities to you guys from a marketing point of view, from a business point of view. I want to make it as interactive as and engaging as possible. So let me know if you're falling asleep. But it's a difficult crowd because some of you will be very much up to date and online. Some of you may not be. I'm going to try and make it relevant for everybody if possible. I've been with the company for about 6 years in Dublin, and this is the very first time that we've actually had an Irish team. So I'm not working with the Irish team, but actually Ross O'Connor is here in the audience as well. He's part of that first team set up in Ireland. We have about six people that are going to be looking to really grow Ireland as a market. We've had a UK and Irish team. We've been focused generally on the larger companies in the UK and the large exporting type companies in Ireland up to this point. But this is the very first time that we're really going to be going out and trying to grow Ireland as a market. So we're seeing the traffic in terms of searches from the users, but we're not seeing the engagement from the businesses. So I want to walk through some of that and some of the opportunities there. So if you do have any questions afterwards, Ross, do you just want to stand up a second just so that everybody can recognize you? I know Vincent wanted to make sure, thanks Ross. Vincent wanted to make sure that it wasn't going to be too Google-centric, but I think it's kind of difficult to talk about online and the trends that we're going to be seeing without talking about Google, but I'll try my best. So the agenda for this evening. So I want to talk a little bit about the internet, the revolution that we're seeing here in Ireland, give you guys some numbers and some steer on some of the trends that we're seeing. I want to talk a little bit about search, online search, what it is, and then the search engine marketing that John spoke about earlier. I won't spend too long on it, but I think I have just a couple of important messages that I want to get across to you guys. Then we go on to some of the trends. So we see this SEO-LOMO. Some of you guys might have seen it before. I'll go into that in more detail. It stands for social, local, and mobile. And then a little bit of a glimpse of the future. Now, I'm going out on a limb this evening. It's going to be very multimedia. I'm going to be doing some presentations, some live demos, some presentations on the mobile. Things are probably going to go wrong, but that's all right. Once we expect them to go wrong, that's fine. Okay, first off, what's happening at the moment? What are the big numbers that we're seeing? So you might have seen this already. We have 2 billion internet users in 2011. So if you look at the world population of 7 billion, in actual fact, we have 5 billion mobile subscriptions. Now, obviously, some people have multiple subscriptions. That's why we're seeing the numbers so high. But it's absolutely mind-blowing where, this number is larger than people who have, correct water to drink. It's absolutely incredible. And a lot of the devices that we're seeing in the emerging markets are already broadband enabled, so they're almost leapfrogging a lot of the new countries at the moment. So it's phenomenal, the growth that we're seeing in mobile. This is one of the main reasons that Google got into mobile. We bought a company a number of years back. We bought in the Android technology and then started developing it, and you guys, I'm sure, would have seen some of the push on Android over the last 2 years. This Christmas, for example, was phenomenal for Android. We were up to 700,000 subscriptions activations a day. So almost a million activations of phones a day. It's absolutely incredible, and it's still growing. But you haven't seen anything yet. The tablet adoption. You guys have known like the iPad. An Android tablet adoption that we've seen this Christmas. This was the Christmas for tablets. We're seeing that in the figures as well for search, or the volume of searches that we're seeing through mobile. We determine the tablet as a mobile device in Google, and we're up to almost 40% of our searches now coming through tablets. So it's absolutely phenomenal. So whatever you do, when you're trying to position yourself online, you've got three devices. You've got the desktop computer, you've got the mobile phone, and you've got the tablet as well. So just be conscious of those different devices and how you engage with your customer on those different devices. YouTube, the amount of video that we're seeing online is absolutely phenomenal. I did a talk with the Chamber 2 years ago. This number was at 16 hours of video uploaded every minute. It's up to 60 hours every minute. This is, we just got that number this morning. It's absolutely tremendous, the amount of growth that we're seeing here. Make sure that you're looking, as a social platform, YouTube is actually fantastic for getting your message out to your customers. When it comes to marketing online, whether you're gonna be using Google or Yahoo or Microsoft, search is still incredibly important. It's not sexy. It's not the YouTubes and the socials of the world. It's not a lot of fun, although once you get into the auction side of things, it can actually be quite fun. But it's just so badly needed. It's the basics. So make sure when you're talking to your clients that you're talking about search. Search first, and then social and display afterwards. So this is the building blocks of online advertising. The best way that I can describe what Google does, you go onto google.com and you put in a couple of keywords. We call them keywords, they're just search terms. So for example, holiday in Spain, and you press return, what happens is you will get a set of results or web pages with information about holidays in Spain, down the middle, and then across the top and down the side, you'll get advertisements. And typically you'd see 8 advertisements down on the right-hand side and possibly 3 across the top, so a maximum of 11. And what has happened in that instant of a moment that it takes for those results to come back is all of those 11 people, companies, have just entered an auction together to compete for the business of your search term, holiday in Spain. So they're competing to show an ad for that holiday in Spain. So the best analogy that I think of this every day of what that is, it's like an auction house. It's like Christie's in London or, you know, and think of Google as being this auction house, and you're walking down the corridor and you look up on one door and you see the name of the auction that's in there. It might be an auction on google.ie, and it's holiday in Spain is the actual, the keywords on the door. And you look in and you see people just bidding for those terms, right? And then you go to the next door and you look in, and it might be on google.co.uk. It's the same search terms, holiday in Spain, but it's a different set of customers, a different set of advertisers that are in there. And it may be more expensive, it may be more intense auction. So there's different auctions that are happening on the different domains. And then you go to the next door and it's just holidays. And that's a different auction again. And there's different people that are in those auctions. Now, what I wanted to show here is the UK business is one of the most mature online markets in the world. But what you're looking at here, I'll just stand out. So you can't actually see it. The top three results there are actually ads, but for the resolution on the screen, it's not really showing. But you've got three ads that are across the top, and you've got eight ads that are down the bottom. So if I was looking in the door of that auction for luxury cosmetics, I would see a very intense auction in there. And it would be a costly auction for these guys to compete against each other. But while an important point about how to get up to the top space here is a combination of the amount of money that you're willing to spend on that particular keyword, plus the quality of your website. Okay, so we take quality into account and we provide a discount against the price. So if you've got a good quality website, and if your ad is very tightly themed to the keywords, and we think that it's a good match, we give you a discount on the actual cost. But if you compare that to the next one, which is the next door down, it's in google.ie, it's the same search terms, and it's an empty auction. You look in the door, and you've got Mr. Google up the top with his hammer going, any bids, and nobody's there, right? If there was one person there, they'd be getting a very cheap auction. So in actual fact, one of the jobs that I do for our largest advertisers is make sure that they get as much traffic that's going to convert, but as cheap as possible. And I try and look for all of those empty auctions. Like, we have tools that try and look for empty auctions to see if we can get an advertiser in and start bidding and get some of that traffic. I mean, it's good for the what we call organic search. But in terms of the advertisers, you know, it's there for the taking. So what I would suggest is there's loads of tools that are out there. There's a great free tool from Google called Insights for Search. Type that into Google and you'll get to the website. And we'll actually show you all of the trends that are happening at the moment within Google Ireland. Or if your market is indeed the UK or Spain, you can put in that market and see how many people are searching on those search terms. And if it's the case that there's a lot of search volume for that, but then you go to google.ie and you search for it and there's nobody advertising against it, there's a cheap auction for you guys. So just have the concept of an auction house in your head when you're thinking of Google, and it should help you identify opportunities as you're trying to grow your business. Does that make sense? Yeah. Okay, so we're seeing good growth in Google Ireland. This is a year over 2 year, 56%. So that's probably about, it's a nice way of probably saying 20% every year for the last 2 years. But what I'll show you another figure later on in the presentation, which is the mobile traffic, which is, so keep the 56% in mind. But that translates to, in terms of retail, a lot of the queries that we're seeing in Ireland are retail-based. And we're seeing in and around 35 retail queries per second. So that will give you an idea of the amount of traffic that's out there at the moment. Okay, so let's get into social and Google. So what we're seeing is, we're seeing social becoming, I was talking to a friend of mine in Facebook recently, and he was saying that Facebook are trying to be the social fabric of the web. And that's where they, you know, anytime that you're logging into any particular site, you have to log in with your Facebook account. One of the reasons for that is Facebook deemed very important the social graph, right? So the social graph determines who is related to who. And it's incredibly important for search, for us. If you're searching for a product on Google.com and you can see somehow that somebody you know has recommended a product in that set of results, you're a whole lot more likely to actually go for that product than if it wasn't recommended. So recommendations from your friends are deemed very, very important in terms of search relevance. Now, if you look at the amount of information that we had on the web 10 years ago compared to now, it's getting more difficult. It's getting more difficult for Google to make sure that the information that you're getting is relevant. Now, that's where we get our competitive advantage, where when there's more information, it takes a lot more computing power, a lot more engineering power for us to get you the best results. And in turn, like, there's about 70% of our engineering resources actually go into making sure that those searches are relevant. So it's a huge part of our business. But social engagement and the social graph is becoming a lot more important in that ranking. And the good news is, I mean, so Irish people, Irish marketeers, 81% of them use social in their marketing. So that's very positive. But I'm going to give you guys a quick look at Google Plus. Okay, how many people in the audience have heard of Google Plus? And how many have a Google Plus account? Okay. So most of you have heard of it. Some of you are using it. I'll show you why it's important, both to you and to Google. So we have Google Plus as a product in itself. I mean, you can think of the product. I'll actually jump into my Google Plus profile just so that you can actually see what it is. Why don't we just do that all together? I'll just go straight to the demo. Okay, so this is what it looks like. So that's a bit small for you guys. Okay, so that's me up in the top left with my little son. I have two boys, 3 and 4, and they keep me very busy and on my toes. So you can see here, this is my stream. I'm following a number of different people. You can see how many are in my circles. I can't really see it there. So I'm following a number of people, a number of people are following me, I'm basically looking at what they're posting. Now, a lot of the growth from Google Plus came around niche areas. It started off in like the likes of the areas of photography, because that's a great one that people will follow. But it's getting a lot more prevalent. Google Plus originally was just for people. It's now for business pages. So you can see here an example of Ford Motor Company. This is their business page on Google Plus. So they have, in this case, so 20,000 people have Ford Motor Company in their circles. So this is a fantastic mechanism for people to engage with their customers. There's one piece of functionality here that I think is going to be very, very big in the future, and that's Hangouts. It's basically the ability to have a video conference with either one person or multiple people, but it's a great way to actually engage with your clients. So what I would recommend is like Google Plus, it just hit the 90 million users last week, but it's growing substantially. It's going to grow very fast, and it's tightly integrated into everything that our company is doing. We're placing a huge bet on social, and you can see how it's actually filtering through into the search results and the ads. Okay, so on the Be Local side of things, how am I doing on time? I'll speed up. This is the multi-channel. John actually alluded to this earlier on, where people are using both the online and offline to do transactions. John Lewis in the UK are ahead of the game on this, and we're doing a lot of work with them. So this is basically where you can maybe order something online, and you go into the store itself and you collect it. Once you get into the store, they actually have people there to upsell you even more stuff. It's becoming very, very big, and I just want to give you a taste of the stuff that you can do with this.
South Korea is a unique market. Tesco has been evolving itself, adjusting to the local market. It even changed the name itself from Tesco to Home Plus. And at last, it grew to rank number 2 in Korea. But Tesco had to overcome one obstacle, a fewer number of stores compared to the number 1 company, E-Mart. Mission: could we become number 1 without increasing the number of stores? We made an in-depth study into Koreans once more. Koreans are the second most hardworking people in the world. For them, grocery shopping once a week is a dreaded task. So we decided to approach these busy and tired people. Idea: let the store come to the people. We created virtual stores, hoping to blend into people's everyday lives. Our first try was subway stations. Although virtual, the displays were exactly the same as actual stores, from the display to the merchandise. Only one thing was different: you used smartphones to shop. Scan the QR code with your phone, and the product automatically lands in your online cart. When the online purchase is done, it will be delivered to your door right after you get home. People can relax more after work and on weekends.
실제로 보면서 사니까 진짜 더 좋은 것 같아요. 편하기도 하고.
Result: people can shop at Tesco Home Plus wherever they go without having to visit the actual store. Moreover, we could change their waiting time to shopping time. After this campaign, online sales increased tremendously. Through this campaign, 10,287 consumers visited the online Home Plus mall using smartphones. The number of new registered members rose by 76%, and online sales increased 130%. Currently, Home Plus has become number 1 in the online market and is a very close second offline.
What do these 4 things have in common? Can anybody guess? I asked this question one time, and a rather smart person in the audience said they all have wheels, but it's not that. eBay. They were with a mobile phone. With a mobile phone. They're all bought with a mobile phone. They're seeing 1 purchase per second at the moment on eBay. It's phenomenal. So we're seeing an incredible growth in mobile across the countries. We're seeing it here in Ireland. So again, this is the year and 2-year growth. We saw the 56% for standard growth for Ireland on the desktop, or in general. It's 294% for mobile. So mobile is absolutely exploding. And you know what? One of those doors in the auctions is a mobile auction. And those auctions are actually cheaper, and people are not in there. It's a less intense auction, and there's a lot more value for money. Just make sure that for your sites, that you have a mobile-enabled site. And as I showed earlier, they're quite easy to make, in relatively speaking. And if you have a good mobile site, then you are going to be able to convert. But also tablets. Tablets can view a standard website almost as good as a desktop. So just some stats here for Ireland. So 46% of Irish mobile owners use the internet on their phone. We have the highest broadband penetration in the most of Europe compared to France, Germany, and the UK. So no, in terms of the mobile advertising, there's a huge opportunity for people to actually use mobile. I can work through with some of you later if you want to do that. But it's cheaper. You can get much better conversions because it's specific to people and what they're looking for. So now a glimpse of the future. Up there. So mobile. One story that I wanted to kind of get across tonight was convergence. So a convergence of technologies, convergence of online and offline media, convergence of local and mobile. And this video next will give you an insight into what's coming. So that's it. I'm going to leave you guys with one message. Things are changing. There's a lot of convergence happening between behavior and technology. Where there's change, there's opportunity. Make sure you're wide open and ready to join the revolution.
I think when I'm doing a Google search and I see the sponsored ads at the top of this page,
yeah.
I often think the sponsored ads will lead me to purchase a product. Whereas very often I'm doing research. Okay, maybe I'm doing research with a view to buying a product. But a lot of the time I will skip past the sponsored ads and go for the unsponsored ones,
yeah,
to find out perhaps more independent information.
Yeah.
So how do you rationalize that? How do you work that one out in terms of giving your customers a ranking, for example?
Yeah. So
or an auction price.
Okay. So one very important part of Google is that those natural results are completely independent of the paid. We've Chinese walls within the companies, within Google, where we cannot actually influence each other. And in actual fact, we're in competition. So those two parts of the business are in competition. So natural search will innovate and they'll come up with a new format, and then they'll put a map over on the right-hand side and cover up our ads, and we'll be like, hold on a minute, you're taking our traffic, and we have to innovate in terms of our product to compete against natural search. And what that provides is two horses running in a race. You're always getting better. You're always improving yourself. So an important part, those two don't mix. What we would say to people is, if I was giving advice, would be make sure that you've got your organic search up to par. Make sure that you're going to be trying to be as high as you can in the organic search. Also do paid search, because if you're seen in both, it actually increases the brand equity. If you expect the best people to be at the top, but if they're a few times at the top, that actually improves as well. Does that answer your question?
Yes, it does.
Yeah.
Do both for both reasons, whether it's a transaction you're looking for or research with a view to doing a transaction later.
Yeah, so actually that's the second part. It all depends on the intent of the user. So if somebody actually wants to purchase something now, they're more than likely going to click on an ad than the organic results, because that ad is somebody's paying to be there. So that means that they've got a product behind the ad that they're willing to sell you right now. It's not always the case in the organic.
So a final thank you to Don. I have a small presentation, if I could get you back on your feet just for a minute. So thanks for going through the trouble. This is a little Graham Nuttall set that I hope you'll enjoy, and thank you very much for all your efforts, all right?
Thanks for having me. Thank you a lot.
My apologies, we've run on a little bit late. I'm sure you understood the material was very, very interesting. And just please stay and join us if you have time. So thank you very much.